Hi students, let's continue with the first order logic in artificial intelligence. In the previous video, I explained about what exactly the first order logic is and what are the syntaxes, the basic elements that we used in the first order logic. Now let's see the sentence. Okay, the sentence here in first order logic, the sentence can be represented atomic sentence or the complex sentence. So what is the atomic sentence and what are the complex sentence? Let's see. The atomic sentence or the most basic sentence of first order logic. Okay, so it's just the most basic sentence of the first order logic. These sentences are formed from a predicate symbol followed by parenthesis with a sequence of terms, means some predicate. So what I said, the predicate is nothing but it's doing some operation. Okay, it's doing some, means the father of, or it is greater than symbol, less than. Okay, it's having some type of relationship. Okay, so the atomic sentence are formed from a predicate symbol followed by parenthesis with a sequence of terms. So it can be represented as predicate. So this is a predicate followed by parenthesis, and within the parenthesis there is a sequence of terms, term 1, term 2, so on, term 1. So this you call it as an atomic sentence. Okay, atomic sentence. Let's see the example here. Hari and Raghu are brothers. So this is a sentence. Okay, so this is a sentence. I represent this sentence in the form of atomic sentence, like by using the predicate and the terms. How? So here the predicate is brothers is a predicate. Brother is a predicate. And the terms are Hari and Raghu are the terms. So this statement can be represented in atomic sentence like this. Brothers, Hari and Raghu. So Hari, Raghu are the brothers. So you can write this statement as like this, brothers of Hari, Raghu, means Hari is a brother of Raghu and Raghu is a brother of Hari, like that. And another example, suppose Tommy is a dog. Here this is only a unique statement, one term is there. Okay, so dog is a predicate and the Tommy is the name of the dog. So here what the terms may be changes, but this is the constant here. Okay, the predicate here in this statement, it is a constant. Dog is a constant and the dog's names will be changed. Means the terms can be changed. So whatever the dogs that are related, means the terms that are related to dogs, those names are writing here. So this is an atomic sentence. Now let's see these complex sentence. The complex sentence are made by combining atomic sentence using connectivities. Okay, so just as a combination of atomic sentence by using the connectivities. I already explained the basic elements of first order logic. It's having some constants, predicates, functions, okay, quantifiers and the connectivities. So connectivities are nothing but the negate, okay, or, and, implies, double implies, bidirectional. So these are all connectivities. So the complex sentence are made up of atomic sentence. Atomic sentence means the predicate with the terms, term 1, term 2, like that. Okay, so it's just a combination of predicate and that are using the connectivities. So if you are using the connectivities to represent the atomic statement, that statement becomes the complex sentence. Now let's see the first order logic statements that are divided into two parts. One is the subject and predicate. So whatever the sentence that we are taken, that sentence is divided into two parts, subject and the predicate. Whether it is an atomic sentence or it may be a complex sentence, it is divided into two parts, subject and predicate. Subject is the main part of the statement. So remember this, subject is the main part of the statement. And the predicate is, a predicate can be defined as a relation which binds two atoms together in a statement. So actually the subject is the main part and the predicate is just a relationship among those main parts which binds two atomic statements together in a statement. Now let's see the example so that you can clearly understood what exactly the subject and predicate is. So here see the example. Consider the statement, X is an integer. So this is a statement I'm taking. So in this statement, X is an integer. So here this statement is consisting of two parts. One is a subject and another is the predicate. Then which one is the subject and which is the predicate? Now let's see. It consists of two parts. X is an integer is a statement. It consists of two parts. First part is X. X is a subject of the statement. Because this is a main part. I don't know who is an integer. So if X is an integer means this becomes the main part. The first part X is a subject of statement. And the second part is rest of thing. Is an integer. This is the second part. It's going to explain what the thing is. What the subject is. Okay, it is an integer. It's just a relation. Okay, it's just giving an information. That is a predicate. Okay, so the second part is an integer is known as a predicate. First part is a subject and second part is a predicate. So see here, X is an integer. So this X you call it as a subject and is an integer is a predicate. So the statement is divided into two parts, subject plus predicate. Thank you.